Episode number one, D'Artagnan's Journey. Our story of D'Artagnan and the Musketeers begins in a quiet little country village in southern France. It is the year of our Lord 1625. And as boys will be boys, our young hero, D'Artagnan, and his childhood rival are battling with wooden swords for the honor of being the best swordsman in the entire village.
You'll regret this.
You're a coward.
I am not a coward. I'm D'Artagnan, and don't you forget it. Now take that back.
Bravo, young man. I've traveled throughout France, and I've seen a lot of young soldiers training, and I'm astonished to see someone as young as you are handling a sword so skillfully. Young man, I salute you.
Thank you, sir. And where do you come from?
Paris.
Paris? Oh, it must be a wonderful city. What do you do in Paris?
I am one of His Majesty's musketeers.
I've heard about your captain, Monsieur Tréville.
Oh, you have you? That's nice. I must go now. I have urgent business to attend to in town.
You do?
I have an appointment with the noblest man in the village of Bern. Yeah!
Oh, wow, he's come to see my dad. This is so exciting.
Hey, wait. I wonder what could be so important to bring him all the way from Paris.
Little does D'Artagnan realize that the message carried by the mysterious visitor will change his simple village life forever.
Now he's coming to my house. You'll see. Huh?
Don't worry about it. He's never been here before, and he just rode past the house.
Well, we better help him. Come on.
Hey, Francois, now who's a coward?
You, and I'll take care of you some other time. But right now, my dad has an important visitor.
A visitor from Paris and a real-life musketeer. Hmm? He's going toward my house. He must have gotten lost.
Oh, hi, teacher.
Yes, I've been waiting for you. You're late for your lesson. I don't know why I waste my time on you. And how'd you get that terrible lump on your head?
It's nothing. I just fell down. Listen, a musketeer is coming to see my dad.
Oh, Francois, I don't want to hear any of your excuses. Your father isn't expecting any visitors, and you know it.
No kidding. A musketeer is on his way.
A musketeer? Do you mean one of Monsieur Tréville's musketeers?
Of course.
Francois, your father is only the mayor of Bern, not the governor of the district. I don't think a musketeer would be visiting him.
I talked to one just now. He's visiting the noblest man in town, and that's my dad.
You're right about that. Huh?
D'Artagnan, do you want to settle our fight right now?
Huh? Thanks for asking, but I'm in a hurry. Bye.
Huh? He never refused a fight before.
Uh-huh. Your mother will be very sorry to hear you've been playing with him again. Don't worry, I won't say a word. D'Artagnan is a bad influence on you, Francois. You must behave more like a male son, and that means cultivating the right kind of friends. Now go away! Come, we must do something about that unsightly lump.
I'll get out of here as soon as I can, and then we'll meet at the usual place, okay? All
right. Had D'Artagnan's eyes been deceiving him? Or did that musketeer actually ride up to his own house? He'd never even seen a musketeer before, much less had one as a guest. His Majesty's Musketeers. They were the king's personal guards, the best swordsmen in all of France, the most loyal, the most brave, and the most honor-bound. But why on earth would such a man come to see D'Artagnan's father?
Please,
please. Won't you sit down?
Pardon me, sir, but I prefer to stand. Monsieur Travel has asked me to behave toward you with the same respect that I would show him.
Really? As if I were still an officer? Travel loves his protocol.
Yes, sir.
Why would a musketeer come all the way from Paris to see my dad? And why isn't he sitting down? Oh, Whiskers, I can't hear a thing.
You may tell Monsieur Travil that I thank him for his letter and his interest. My reply will be delivered personally by the individual concerned.
Yes, sir. I know the captain will be very pleased to hear the good news.
Maybe they want to send him on a special mission. Oh, or maybe we'll be moving to Paris to live at the court. Or maybe... Oh, stop imagining things. It was only a letter.
It has been an honor to meet you, sir.
Goodbye.
So, we meet again, lad.
Yes, sir. Hello, sir.
Well, that Monsieur D'Artagnan is quite a man. You're very lucky to have a master who teaches you to handle a sword so well.
Yeah.
Very few servants are so fortunate. You should be grateful.
I am, sir.
Well, the road to Paris is a long one. Goodbye, lad, and hold fast to your sword.
Yeah, goodbye, sir. Hey, wait a minute. I'm not a servant. I'm Monsieur D'Artagnan's son.
Really? You must come to visit me in Paris sometime.
Thank you very much, sir. I will.
Au revoir.
Au revoir, sir. Paris. Oh, I'd love to go to Paris. I sure hope he meant that.
D'Artagnan?
Yep.
Why don't we go out back and I'll show you how the cavaliers handle their swords.
Okay.
All right now, salute. En garde. Ha. Now, I'll thrust against your lateral defenses. Don't just depend on your eyes, son. You have to use all five of your senses. Think of the sword as a part of yourself. Someday your life may depend upon that reflex.
Mon Dieu! Madame, the mayor's wife has come to see you, and she doesn't look very happy.
Dad, I think somebody's here.
If they want anything from me, they'll come and get me. Come on, lad.
Why, Madame Lavache, how kind of you to visit us. We never see enough of you in this part of town. To what do we owe this honor?
I had hoped I would never have to complain again.
Oh, no, my son's been on his best behavior.
Well, I'd say you've given your son a very odd standard of good behavior. Francois has a lump this big on his poor head.
I'm sorry. I shall have another talk with him.
My husband and I are very worried about this situation. Your son abuses Francois nearly every day.
I'm so sorry. His father and I will talk to him tonight. The mayor's wife came by to see me this afternoon.
I know. I could hear her shouting and carrying on. I didn't think she was ever going to leave. Hey, now I know why the mayor spends so much time at the town hall.
No, he spends all his time at the town hall playing cards. But seriously, dear, we should talk about this. He wouldn't be getting in this kind of trouble if his father hadn't brought him up with a sword in his hand. We shouldn't train our children to kill one another. It's just not right.
Again, I'm not teaching him to kill. I'm teaching him to defend himself and his country. A true French cavalier will only fight for noble causes or when his honor is at stake.
Yes, but he thinks of his sword as a plaything. I'm so worried about poor Francois's health.
He'll be all right. A lump on the head might do him some good. And they don't need their dear old mothers fighting their battles for them. He's not a child anymore, and he'll have to face some things by himself. Pah!
Huh? What was that? Huh? It's a letter from Francois.
The fight isn't over yet, D'Artagnan. Today at noon, I'll be waiting at the usual place. We'll see who's a coward. I'm ready for you. Sincerely, Francois Lavache.
And I'm ready for you, Francois.
Tie them as tight as you can.
Is this tight enough for you?
Uh-huh. And how are you doing? here. Now let's cover it up. Pile them higher. This road needs to be blocked. D'Artagnan has to come by this road, and that means he has to fall into one of the traps we've set. Now everybody hide. I think we've got everything set up just right. That D'Artagnan won't get away from me this time.
That Francois is up to his old tricks again. He thinks he's so smart, but I'm much smarter.
My armor has walked away.
Darling, look.
What is it?
I just found this letter in Doggy's room. Look.
Now let's have a look at this. The boys are just having fun. Puppy play.
I can't be so calm about it. You said it yourself, dear. They're not puppies any longer. They're big and strong and can hurt each other. You must stop them.
Meanwhile, at the usual place, the fearless Francois and his brave men were preparing themselves for the battle.
No sign of him at all?
Not a whisker.
That's strange. He's never missed a fight before.
Francois! Huh? I hope I didn't keep you waiting for me.
So you need a coat of armor, eh? You coward!
Well, it's better to be safe than sorry. Some soft grass.
I'll just have to catch him in another trap.
So what are you waiting for, Francois?
I'm waiting for you to stop playing your stupid tricks. Now come out of that armor and fight me, D'Artagnan!
And speaking of stupid tricks, what are all those boys doing in the bushes? Very courageous, Francois.
All right, you asked for it. Attack!
Let's go! Let's go!
Oh, Francois, there's only seven of you. This'll be easy.
D'Artagnan, you're a trickster and a coward, and I'm sending you away from here with your tail between your legs. Now go and get him, boys!
Oh, how does it feel? Now come and get me.
Attack! Get him all together now!
Hey, you guys, stop tickling me.
Come at him, D'Artagnan, and admit that I beat you.
It's a dummy.
You're the dummy.
Huh?
Who do you think you're talking to, eh, Francois?
You can't get out of it. Come down here and fight.
All right, Francois, but you better be ready.
What are you waiting for? We can beat him.
You can try, but I'm going to get you for the way you set those traps. It's a matter of honor. I'll teach you to be sneaky.
Hey, wait. Where are you going?
I got a clavichord lesson.
Uh-oh.
Cowards! Francois, you can't run away now.
The next time I see you, beware of my bite.
We won't worry about the terms of surrender. You have my leave to go now, Francois. And if anyone asks you for the strongest man in Bern, send him to D'Artagnan. Now they'll finally respect me. Ah, they're such fools.
You're the fool.
Hello, Father.
It's time you learned the sword is not a toy. Now throw that piece of wood aside and fight with this.
Yes, sir. Wow. Heavy, isn't it?
The blade has not been sharpened, but it's still very different from that wooden toy of yours. If you miss a single blow, you could wound yourself or even die. You've been using your sword like a child. Now you must learn to use it like a D'Artagnan. On guard!
Oh!
Oh, You should learn to be more humble, son.
Yes, you're right.
Get up now.
Huh?
On your feet, lad.
Oh, golly, I can hardly walk.
It's the first time he's handled a real sword, and he almost beat me. Son, you're someone special. Let's go home, son. I smell a rainstorm.
Hey, Dad, wait for me.
So you've decided to send him to Paris?
He'll be all right under Monsieur Treville's protection. Anyway, a boy his age should be off looking for adventure in the city, not sitting around in some old farmhouse talking to his parents. He wants to be a musketeer. Treville is my friend, so I'm sending him to Paris.
I'll miss him very much. I love him so.
Yes, I know. I love him too.
I've never seen such a beautiful suit, Mom.
I wish you'd had better things. Here, try it on.
Hey, look at that collar.
A gentleman of means.
Mm-hmm.
This is for you, son. I used this sword in many battles with King Henry IV. You may only use it when necessary in the defense of your king and country. Avoid dueling, but never dishonor the name of D'Artagnan.
Yes, sir. Wait a minute. I don't get it. What have I done to deserve all this special treatment?
It's what you're going to do. My friend Monsieur Treville has agreed to take you under his protection in Paris.
I'm going to Paris? Is he telling the truth, Mom?
Of course.
Paris is a big city. A very, very, very big city.
What's the matter, son? Aren't you excited?
Oh, I'm excited, Dad, but this is pretty sudden.
My motto is never hold good news by the tail.
What is it, Mom?
Don't cry, honey. He had to leave us sometime.
I know.
Your steed awaits you outside.
A horse? Just like a real gentleman. Huh? Is that my horse?
Yes, that's Sandy. You couldn't really call him a thoroughbred, but he'll come in handy when you need him.
He's very nice, Dad. Woo-hoo-hoo! Whoa! Thanks, Sandy. Well, this is it. I love you both and will miss you very much.
We love you too, son. Now take this letter and deliver it personally to Monsieur Treville in Paris.
To Monsieur Treville, from your old friend.
We were friends many years ago. Give him my greetings, son.
It'll be my honor.
D'Artagnan.
Yes?
I hope you'll never have to use this gift. It's an ointment, and it will cure any wound. I've also saved a few coins to help you get started in Paris. We love you, son. Take good care of yourself, and God bless you.
Thanks so much, Mom.
My darling.
I love you, Mom. Goodbye.
And so young D'Artagnan set off by himself on the long road to Paris. What direction would his life take? How far would he travel? And when would he see his dear parents again? D'Artagnan's mind was filled with melancholy thoughts as he passed the outskirts of town, the village where he had spent his whole life. But what's this?
What are you doing here, Francois?
I heard you were leaving for Paris.
That's right. Would you like to have one last fight before I leave town for good?
No, we'll leave it for another time.
Oh, then did you come to say goodbye to me?
We all came down to see you off. It was Francois' idea.
Huh? Oh, be quiet, you big numbskull. Don't listen to him, D'Artagnan. I just had to come down to see the town's biggest nuisance finally go.
You honor me, Francois. I'm pretty glad I won't have to be seeing your dirty muzzle anymore either, you know. Farewell. Been a pleasure.
D'Artagnan? We hope you can come back and see us. Good luck.
Thank you, Francois. Thank you very, very much.
D'Artagnan looked back on his little village and on all his old friends. He was actually on his way to Paris to be a great musketeer. The future held a dream, a promise of adventure with new friends in a new city. Friends who would be with him through thick and thin, one for all and all for one.
In the next episode, we'll see Dog Tanyan riding on horseback to Paris. Along the way, he'll have a very disagreeable encounter that will end in a duel with a knight that our friend will nickname Black Mustache.